Hi everyone. I'm Duke. Welcome back to The Binding of Isaac. It has been quite a while since I've streamed this game. I was hoping I would be able to stream The Binding of Isaac Rebirth, remake of this game, that comes out today, technically, but it will not unlock until 1 o'clock p.m. my time, which is 6 o'clock or 1800 UTC. So, since I can't stream Rebirth, I thought I would go back to the game that I streamed so much, that I loved a lot. Unfortunately, I do not have my save with everything unlocked. I've reformatted my hard drive since I stopped playing this game, and this game does not have Steam Cloud support. So, all I have is this save. I've beaten Mom's Heart, as you can see by the graphic here, and I've unlocked a few of the items, but not, most of the cool stuff has not been unlocked. So I apologize for that. If I had thought ahead, I would have used Cheat Engine or something to go in and unlock everything. But hopefully I can play a couple games and at least have a successful run at Mom's Heart. I don't think I'll be able to do Sheol or the Cathedral or anything like that. I don't know. I'm not sure if you have to beat Mom's Heart like 10 times for those to unlock, or if that's just for the achievement, or I don't know. I'm not sure how it works. Anyway, enough of my yapping. So I haven't even unlocked my favorite character yet. Hey, PokeMat28, welcome. Oh, thanks for saying something. You remind me to sync the chat. Thank you, Nightbot. So yeah, I haven't had a run on the save where I collected 55 pennies. Not sure why pennies are in quotes. I mean, they are pennies. Not sure what's up with the scare quotes. I do have Magdalene, who I will probably go with as my second pick. I haven't even unlocked Eve. I haven't unlocked Samson, which he's not one of my favorite characters. And of course I have Judith, who is probably my least favorite of the characters, besides a Blue Baby. Isn't Blue Baby usually on this menu, just grayed out, kind of like Eve is? I thought Blue Baby was visible, just name was represented by question mark. I'm not sure. Oh well. Since this is the send-off stream for The Binding of Isaac, I'm probably play Isaac, the namesake of the game. Of course, I'm making a lot of noise about never playing this game again after Rebirth comes out. It's quite possible Rebirth will suck, and this will still be the game of choice. I mean, you never know. Rebirth looks really good, but stranger things have happened. Hello, Nixil Umbreon. What's going on with The Binding of Isaac? Well, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth comes out today, in about 13 hours, and I thought, you know, I've been excited about Rebirth for a while, and I thought I would give The Binding of Isaac the farewell it deserves, because I streamed this game a lot back in the day. I have numerous videos on my YouTube account of me playing this game. Hey Sarah the Lich. Oh, good luck in Payday 2. Okay, so I got a pretty good item. I guess I could search for the secret room. It's probably here. If I had to put money on it, I would bet here. Nope, okay. This is my second choice. Excellent. Two bombs to get. Ooh, yonk. Not sure how much good it's going to do me, but I guess that's worth two bombs. Playing for 13 hours till it comes out. I don't think so. I mean, I won't be playing for 13 hours. Oh, yeah, this will not be my final stream. I am not retiring from the world of streaming and LP just yet. I have not gotten nearly famous enough for that to happen yet. I mean, retiring when nobody knows who you are is just kind of sad. I guess I should have been more clear in the title of the stream, so I apologize if I freaked anyone out unnecessarily. So, I just got done playing a bunch of Olly Olly. I picked that game up in the most recent Humble Bundle. And man, that game is really good. I am enjoying that game so far. I think that might be my new chill stream game, because my last chill stream game was Splunky, and I've gotten all the achievements in Splunky, so I'm pretty much done with that game. You know who I am. Oh well, thank you, Pokemon. But you know. I meant more the internet at large does not know who I am. You know, when I said everybody, I was being... So yeah, I said I was going to try to get all of the achievements in Splunky during a stream, or while I was streaming, but I moved recently, and I ended up having a lot of free time where I did not have the internet, and the thing I did was I just... I played Splunky a lot, and I got all the achievements. It was pretty satisfying, I have to say. After all this time, after that, it was almost a year to the date since Splunky HD came out, or since I got Splunky HD, that I got all the achievements. So I'm feeling pretty good about that. So yeah, I might revisit Splunky someday, but not anytime soon. Maybe when Splunky HD Rebirth comes out. Which, you know, it's just a matter of time. I think I'll save my key for the item room. But yeah, Olly Olly. It's like a 2D skateboarding game with sort of retro style graphics. And I was a big fan of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 back in the day. That's the only skating game I ever really played. And, Olly Olly is really, really scratching that itch. It's a really cool game. Not sure if I will stream it anytime soon because I have this tonight, and then tomorrow will be Rebirth, and then Moores and I are still going to try to do Saints Row 4 at some point this week, because we're almost done with the story, and I kind of like to go on ahead and finish that up. And there are plans in the works for Moores to come over and record some Rebirth co-op with me. Since that game is local co-op only, you would have to actually physically come to my apartment, which, you know, he lives near me, so it's not a big deal. The stream tomorrow will be at 1 o'clock p.m., which is 6 o'clock p.m. UTC, or 1800 UTC. So, you know, do the math and figure out when it is in your local time zone. That's when the game unlocks, at least according to Steam. If something happens and the game does not unlock, then I will stream something else. What other games have I been looking at? I haven't really been playing a ton of games lately. Since I finished up Splunky, I've been playing a little bit of Shantae on the Game Boy Color. I picked that up on the 3DS Virtual Console. Hey, cool. Oh, man. The game did not like that. That was a little bit too much on the screen at once. And you can see the massive slowdown that The Binding of Isaac is famous for, because there's so much shit on the screen, which Rebirth is supposedly going to fix, because it's not made in Flash anymore. Or Rebirth is not made in Flash. Wait, aren't there supposed to be three waves? Oh, maybe it glitched because I got the achievement or whatever, and it gave me all three waves at once. Yeah, as far as new games go, Olly Olly is pretty much it, and I picked up the Humble Bundle on a whim because I've watched some people play Olly Olly before, and it looked like fun. I also got another game in that bundle that was of interest to me. Can't think of what it is at the moment. Oh yeah, Jazz Punk. I'll definitely be doing a blind stream of Jazz Punk at some point. Because that game looks really cool. Also, I think someone requested that game at some point, so I'm glad I have it now so I can do that. Stream lag is gone. Oh, was there lag? That sucks. Yeah, everyone, let me know if, you know, audio-visual stuff is good, you know, as usual. Oh, got some dinner. Cool. I only have one key and only 3 coins, so no point in going into the item shop. Let's see if I can get that secret room. Yeah! First try. Well, have some more money now. Would the item shop be worth it? Probably not. I'm gonna hold on to my key for the item room. How's everyone doing? I'm doing well, just dropped. Thanks. I'm settled into the new apartment. It is way better than my last place. Aw, man, library or item room? Tough call, because if it's a library, there's a good chance of me getting the Book of Revelation. But it could just be Anarchist Cookbook or something crappy. I feel like there's more echo or something in my voice because my new apartment has hard floors instead of carpet. It's like this, they're called laminate floors. You know, it's like a fake wood grain kind of look, but it's made out of vinyl or something. And hopefully that is not too distracting. I don't have anything on my walls to like mitigate the echo or anything. But yeah, I have tomorrow off work for election day, which is how I was able to stream this late in the first place. I need to remember to upload the most recent Saints Row video tonight, because I've been forgetting to do that. So yeah, I have all the achievements in this game except for get through the different areas without taking damage. I got the achievement for the basement, called Basement Boy. I don't know why I didn't use that. But I have not made it through the caves or... God, I forget what the other level is called. I know the Wrath of the Lamb version is called the Necropolis. Book of Shadows. Book of Shadows is useful, especially if you get a blood bank, because you can trigger the shield and use the blood bank a bunch of times without taking damage. Yes, I am. I'm famous for forgetting to use my items, so if I forget, feel free to remind me. So yeah, Rebirth should be adding a whole bunch of cool new stuff to the game. I mean, there's a co-op mode, which I'm not sure how that's going to work, actually. Might be a little bit too chaotic for two people to play at once on the same screen. I don't know. I'll have to wait and see how that is. But I believe I might be making this up, or maybe I dreamed it. But I think that there's some sort of daily challenge type thing, like what Smunky has, where everyone gets the same random seed and I'm not sure. I might be thinking of a different game. Yes, the depths. Thank you, Twisted. It would definitely be cool if this game had that, but it doesn't. I will try not to be disappointed. You can tell how long it's been since I played because I forgot the word depth. But I think there's also like a level editor, and levels can be way bigger than, or rooms can be way bigger than they are in this game. In this game, they're all pretty much just square, you know, maximum of four doors in each room. And in Rebirth, rooms can be, you know, eight-sided with multiple exits leading out. I don't think you can have like diagonal exits, but you can have like two doors in one wall, and like they can be shaped a way besides just rectangular. It'd be pretty cool. I have a bunch of money, so let's see what's in here. Not really worth it. I guess I'll pick that up and replace my key. Hopefully the Steam sale will pay off. So yeah, new engine to play better. You can use a controller without having to use joy to key, but that's another thing I'm not sure about. Not really sure how well the game will play with a controller. Might just stick with using a keyboard. I remember having a lot of trouble with this boss the first time I ever fought it. I think I was just too slow to deal with it. Because it's really no different than, not that much different than Gemini. As long as you don't walk on the trail of blood. Yeah, that's true, Just Rob. Getting the Steam sale this early should be worth it. Oh, hey, this guy. If I had some way to teleport out of this room, I would probably do that rather than fighting him. Because the coal, he always drops coal, and okay, I mean, it's not the most useful item in the world. Stop it! My tarot card. All that does is separate my head from my body, so I can float over pits and stuff, which is why I haven't been using that. Wouldn't be the most useful thing right now. Oh, that sucks, Twisted. I hope the appointment goes well. Assuming Greed isn't on every floor afterward. Well, knowing me, he probably will be. I always forget you can hit space to skip those little cutscenes. I mean, I've seen them all at this point. No point in rewatching all of them multiple times. My damage is pretty good right now. That sucks, Twisted. But I'm glad you are, seeing someone about it. I hope it helps. I can definitely relate. Alright. See what new card I get. Devil. Better than the Hanged Man. I don't think I'll go in that pain room. Crap. I knew I was going to get myself cornered. It's a crappy layout. This room. Well, Sarah, because I picked up the coat hanger item, which increases the power of my shots, and the reason my face looks like that is because I got the growth hormone, which makes me a little faster and stronger, but also kind of deforms me. Yeah, if you've never watched this game or played this game, your character can get some pretty interesting power-up combination that make you look and frightening. So check for a secret door there. Nice! Getting pretty lucky with these. Aw. Been nothing but coins, though. Well, and the Ankh. Forgot I had the Ankh. That doesn't really show up on my, well, I guess it would show up on my character if my face wasn't like that. Yeah, basically, he is the result of a botched coat hanger abortion. At this point, he could turn into something else. I could be an angel with devil horns and two butts. Well, I have the steam sail, so I might as well blow one of my keys. Ooh, compass would be useful. I'll take it. I could be, a Cthulhu monster that vomits up geysers of blood. Yeah, if this is the first time you've seen this game, anyone in the chat room right now, it's pretty gross. I realize I'm being nonchalant about the grossness, but, I'm pretty used to it by this point. So, if you don't like the grossness, I totally understand. But, grossness aside, it's a really fun game. Oh, hey, Bippo, what's up? Speaking of grossness, I played Cards Against Humanity for the first time the other day. We only had a group of four people, which isn't the ideal setup for that game. Man, is that game fun. It's like, you know how video games make you feel like a badass, when they're well done? Cards Against Humanity makes you feel like you're funny. Like, even if you technically don't come up with the cards, playing them at the right moment and, using them in clever combinations to make everyone else laugh. That is a really good feeling. What does the stars do? That takes you somewhere, right? I think it takes you to the item shop. Man, I am definitely not going to remember all the tarot cards. I think I might want to just hang on to the devil. Oh, four people was best, Sarah? Well, maybe we had the best experience with it. Yeah, I can see how having a larger group can kind of make it drag on and, oversaturate you with the game. But when we played, way too long. I ended up winning the game with, 25 points, and you're only supposed to play to, 7 or 8 or something. I think we went through, half the black deck. Or possibly a little bit more. It got dull. Yeah, I can see that. Especially if you've already seen a lot of the combinations and kind of know what's coming up. But we got the first expansion for it, and we will probably end up picking up all of the other expansions eventually. Alright, I wish there was another heart so I could get myself up to full health and go into that challenge room. Oh well, I guess I will just take on the boss. Well, after I get through this room. Oh god, that slowdown. I have a pretty good computer too. I think my computer's technically better than it was the last time I streamed this game, because I've upgraded my graphics card since then. So yeah, even on beastly computers, it can run Crysis 2 at 120 frames per second in 1440p, the original Binding of Isaac still chugs. Hey Chubb. Well, I was gonna use my devil card, but I don't think I wanna use it on Chubb. This is one of the easier bosses. I mean, I hate to generate all these cards that I'm not gonna use, but I haven't really had a reason to use any of them yet. Could feed him a bomb. Yeah, he blowed up real good. My favorite Cards Against Humanity combination that I played, it was step one blank, step two blank, step three profit. And for step one, I played saving 15% by switching to Geico. And for step two, I played Hurricane Katrina. Step three profit. Which, you know, I thought was pretty clever. You know, it makes sense. Switching or getting insurance right before a big disaster, you know, that would be profitable. Of course, you know, it's funnier in context when, you know, everyone's around the table and, you know, you have multiple plays to choose from. And then, for the haiku, one of my friends played, basically a haiku about RoboCop committing genocide on poor people, which that got him a point. That was a pretty good one. Isaac is a game and a half. Oh, because I have the original game and the expansion. Yeah, I guess that's true. That might be making a chug a little bit more as well. Or if you just mean it's like a big game. Yeah, you pretty much are constantly sobbing and screaming, Twisted. That's what this game's all about. I hate these guys. Right, so I'm in the depths. This is when the game starts ramping up the difficulty. So I'm doing okay so far. You know, not to jinx it or anything. Two farts. Oh, that just gives you, I think it doubles the amount of farts you have, which I'll leave that there. Yeah, I could quickly turn this into the tasteless stream by just talking about Cards Against Humanity combinations. And, you know, I understand that kind of humor isn't for everyone, but, I had a pretty good time with it. Oh, Wheel of Fortune. I can just go ahead and use that one. The slot machine. I only have two coins, but maybe I'll get lucky. Well, worth a shot. All right, let's. That way it looks like it leads to the boss. So let's go this way. Of course, I say this could turn into the tasteless stream, which is ironic because I am playing the Binding of Isaac. It's kind of already the tasteless stream. Gambling doesn't pay. It certainly didn't pay off for me, but maybe I just didn't do enough gambling. Tower, that's the one that that drops kind of bombs everywhere. So I should probably pick up the devil instead. Under that, the devil, it just it beats up your attack. That's pretty much it, I think. Patience, circle strafe the meat. Yeah, I'm hanging out with the devil. How do you get your money back? More gambling. Well, if I was Kane, I would have like a 33% better chance of winning in slot machines, so that would actually be the case. Or something like that. I'm not sure what the actual percentage is. Of course, if I want to unlock Kane, I really shouldn't be spending all this money. I forget if this is good or not. I think that's the bloodlust that Samson starts with, and all that does is make you do more damage the more enemies in a room you kill. Yep, that's it. Because it gives you Samson's hairband. It's a good item. That is a good find. Happy with that. I guess it doesn't matter if I unlock Kane or not, since more than likely I won't be coming back to this game. I am expecting Rebirth to be good. Well, I just came in here hoping for the Book of Revelation, and it doesn't look like I'm going to get it. I could always blow up the arcade. Yeah, good point. I also need to search for secrets. Now it looks like I should probably grab this key, well, or maybe both keys. I do have 11 bombs. You can thank Justrot for that, Bippo. He was very, very generous, and he gifted us both a copy of the game. We haven't played yet. We've been waiting for an opportunity where the three of us can play co-op, and it's been difficult to schedule that. I think Moores was going to talk to Just Drop about seeing about, oh, fuck you. Goddamn troll bomb. Discuss with Just Drop about playing this week because he'd be able to play a day he normally wouldn't be able to play. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if he mentioned that to you, Just Drop. I think he was saying Sunday was the day he can play because you said you would only be available on weekends for a while. Not sure, but you know, hopefully we'll work something out sooner or later. Okay, awesome. Yeah, definitely looking forward to that. Oh, I hate these guys. Oops, wrong button. I meant to use the bomb button. I don't know how I hit Q instead of E, but there you go. And my hands are falling asleep. I forgot how awkward this position is with both my hands on the keyboard. Oh, hey, cool. Thanks, Cyanide Sprite. Appreciate it. That means a lot to me. Yes, I envy his generosity too. I wish I could be that generous. But on the plus side, now that I'm, I guess I could bomb this and check for secret passages at the same time. I think that identifies pills, or maybe it gives you better pills. I forget which one. But yeah, now that I moved in, settled into the new place, I'm not quite as destitute as I was at the time. Alright, have I checked this wall? Don't think so. Oh right, fuck! Forgot about this room. Oh well. One hit to get all these bombs, I guess it's worth it. Alright, what is the ideal way to go through here? Oh, not like that. Yet. Oh, more frequently. Okay, that's cool. Thanks, Just Drop. Let's test that wall, I guess. Nope. Also a gray block over here. Hopefully there will be something good in that. Nope. Well, I guess I got a soul heart and a bomb. It's not all that bad. I know Cyanite's right, but there are also the Wrath of the Lamb secret rooms, which are only adjacent to one room. Also, secret rooms can be adjacent to two rooms. It's not as likely, but it's definitely happened to me before. Man, wish I had my lasers. I've not seen technology yet since I started playing a new save. Kind of a bummer. I really like technology. Shit. I got more pills. Oh! Alright, strength. That makes you do a little bit more damage, I think. I don't think the secret room can be here. But I think I've checked every other obvious location. Right here. Right here. Well, maybe I'm mistaken. Oh! Well, apparently they can be adjacent to four rooms. Because this one is. Alright, see you later, Nixwell and Brian. Thanks for hanging out. Well, three or four rooms. Yeah, I've seen it adjacent to unless you mean like diagonally adjacent to three rooms. Because like for example, I've seen a secret room like in this position on the map, which technically it's only adjacent to that room and that room, unless you're counting that, which isn't really adjacent. At least not in the logic of this. Bomb into the shop and pray for. Why would I pray for that? Hate greed. YOLO, I guess. Or something. Nice! And I still get hit. I have never fought greed without getting hit at least once. This never happened in the history of humanity. Oh, I should have gone back into this room and dropped some coins into that slot machine. Oh well. I don't like that version of the slot machine that much anyway. Well, still full up on hearts, so I don't need the two of hearts just yet. Well, I might as well pick it up since I don't have a card right now. Oh, so I get some money. Yeah, it didn't drop that much, but... Oh well. Alright, what you got for me, Depths? Oh. Right. Monstro 2, eh? That's not that bad. You just have to be a little quick on the draw. And, notice when he's about to do the blood vomit attack, which he telegraphs it, you know, pretty far in advance. Usually have enough time to get away, unless you're super slow, which my character is pretty fast at the moment, which is good. My stats are all really great. I haven't found any awesome items, but activated items, but all of my stats are really fantastic for this run. Especially now that I have that bloodlust. Look at how much damage I'm doing per hit now that I've killed all of the flies and stuff. Just fantastic. Ha! Damn it. Avoid the blood vomit and hit by a dumb fly. Oh well. Bad gas, telepills. Hey, tears up. I'll take it. And some flies. Alright. What do I want to take with me? Probably the two of hearts. Yeah, definitely. I could go back for that strength card, but... eh. Oh, item room's pretty close. Good sign. Damn it. I don't have any orbitals in this run. Well, except for my attack fly. That doesn't really protect me from projectiles. Normally I have like at least a hunk of meat or something floating around me. Or a baby of some kind. Not this time. Unicorn Horn A. I think that's a little better than the tarot deck. Pretty useful. Yeah, I haven't fought any of the horsemen yet. Pretty sure I've unlocked them at this point. Friday. Be proud of this. Sucker. Of course, the unicorn horn does recharge painfully slow, but oh well. Hate those the guys that shoot out the maggots. I think it just does tremendous amount of damage. I think it's two hearts if you get hit by the maggot. Seem to remember, or maybe that's just on the uterus. Maybe it's just one heart normally. I don't know. There's a lot I forget about this game, but at the same time, no, a lot of it's coming back to me. Get away from me. That guy, eh? Well, if the shop doesn't have anything, then I might feel generous. Away from me. Thank you. That worked out well. Right. Plenty of keys, so no reason not to go in the shop. Oh, I can get the Minecraft axe. Able to break blocks. Eh. Alright, beggar. I've listened to your plea, and you make a good case. Oh, that was well worth it. I haven't seen an arcade yet, either. I guess I haven't had enough money to hit an arcade. Usually, they only pop up if you have a lot of coins. I do like this item. The rotten head. Don't think it's better than the unicorn. I do like being able to poison a large group of enemies. Pretty useful. But I think I'll hang on to the horn. Key and a bomb. Might as well. I think that's telepills. No, tears up. Excellent. Well worth it. Attack still has room for improvement. Alright. I never do the blood splatter rooms. Never worth it. You hit, you know, X number of times and all you get for it is a chest that probably doesn't contain anything good. Man. Most annoying enemy in this game. That possibly the Mask of Infamy. Which is the same enemy, just bigger, really. unlucky with the pills so far. No debuffs or anything yet. These guys are fast. Aw, oh, jeez. I was saving that for the boss, but you know, some things are just more annoying than the boss. Look at how easily Larry goes down. My god. Unlike the Terminator, but for worms. The Worminator, if you will. Shit. That enemy's pretty damn annoying, too, I have to admit. But, that's just the sound, not mechanics. Let me take a drink. Alright, Mom. Make sure there's nothing else I want to do on this level. Nope, I'm good. We have all this money. It's a shame there's no slot machine or anything because there are no shops in the next area. But oh well. My range is still pretty crappy. That's the one of. The one stat I haven't gotten any buffs for yet. Gotta make sure not to get too close to these doors. Watch out for the shadow. Don't get hit by the blood. Alright, the Magic 8 Ball. Oh yeah, that's just tears out, never mind. I was thinking of a different item. Yeah, the Magic 8 Ball is excellent. No reason not to get that. And there's a death card here. Oh, I guess that spawned when I got the 8 Ball. I'll hang on to death. That's a good one. Alright, I'm just gonna go the shortest path possible to the boss. Use my keys because, again, there are no item rooms. No real reason to hang on to them. I was thinking the 8 ball was the crystal ball, which is one of the better items in the game, but nope. It was just a stat buff. Hey, it's Trippy Larry. I don't conform to your 90 degree angles, man. Are just the man trying to keep you down. Best way to kill a doppelganger. And okay, I guess. Oh yeah, I still need to look for secrets as well. Bunch of money I don't really need. You're here? Nope. Alright, if there's no secret in the other corner, then I'm not going to bother searching for it, because I don't want to go to more of the map than is necessary. All Alright, what you got for me, boss room? Oh, hey, death. I wonder if the death card is effective against death. I'm gonna take a guess and say probably not. Damn, when did my shots get so fast? Didn't realize. I guess it's all those tears up cards. Hey. Didn't realize that recharged already. I guess it has been several rooms since I used it. Damn it! Well, I took some damage, but I got most of it back. Now I get the cube of meat. Well, of course I did, because it was one of the four horsemen. Okay. Don't want to look at any more of this level. I'm good. Hang on to my death card for Mom's heart. And I should be good to go. A library over there, but it's not really worth going through all those rooms to get to it. In utero, or the womb, the best strategy is the shortest strategy. Shit. I mean, unless you're just an unstoppable killing machine. Aw, oh, damn it, I should have used that bomb to look for a secret passage. Oh well. There's a gambling room coming up, so I might get some more bombs. Oh, I remember. If you haven't beaten Mom's Heart like 10 times, you have a chance of going to Sheol, but it's not a guaranteed thing. Whereas if you beat her a bunch of times, then every time you beat Mom's Heart, a door to Sheol opens. Sheol or the cathedral. Alright, if I can spawn some hearts, I might be able to try to get something for that blood bank. Not super likely though. On the plus side, we get to enjoy this awesome version of the music. And have you guys heard any of the music for Rebirth yet? It is really good. Like, I really like the soundtrack in this game. But from what I've heard of Rebirth, it might be better. It's a lot darker, kind of industrial sounding almost. I'm not sure who did the soundtrack, but a couple tracks I heard sounded really good. I don't think I want to use these telepills. They probably just screw me by taking me further away from the boss. Well, I got something on the first heart, but it's the wrong item. I don't want the portable blood bank. Hey, Skelekey. There are any locked doors on this level? I got them. Probably not very likely, because there's just one more room before the boss. Yes, this is always the most boring part of any Binding of Isaac stream, but, I mean, I have to, or I might as well spend all these coins, since I have them. Only 7 more to go. I wish the blood bank dropped the health upgrade and not the portable blood thing. I mean, I guess I could use that and get some more coins. You know, cycle through these hearts. but ultimately, I don't really think there's much point. Alright, I just want to quit now, since I have enough bombs to test the walls I want to test. Oh, thank you, Bippo. I'm glad somebody does. Yeah, I don't want to go looking for trouble, so I'm done. Kaiji? Not familiar with that. Oh. Well, I could blow this guy up. It'll probably just turn into spiders or something. I don't really want to give him hearts. That's this wall. Nope. Well, shit. There are still a couple hearts in the gambling room, right? Yeah, okay. I'll give you 2 hearts, Mr. Devilman, but that's it. The moon, eh? I think the moon takes you to the secret level, or the secret room. Pretty sure. Let's test. I did. Well, hey. Go outside. I've been outside. Like, I went outside a whole bunch over the weekend. I saw the movie Gone Girl, which I thought was pretty good. Not the best ending ever, but I really like David Fincher, and I had a good time watching it. And then that was Friday, and then on Saturday, I saw the movie Only Lovers Left Alive, the new Jim Jarmusch movie. Really like that one. Soundtrack was fantastic. And the movie itself was really cool too. Maybe I should pick up some of these hearts. And have to spend a bomb to get that one. And a bomb to get that one. Okay, I'll trade 1 bomb for 1 heart, but not half a heart. Hey, I unlocked Mr. Mega. That's a good way to cap off my Binding of Isaac career. Oh yeah. Alright. 1 more heart, Mr. Devilman. I mean, I'll be down half a heart, but hey, worked out. Of course, the PhD won't help me that much at this point. Bitter Pills does not change bad gas into anything. Shit. Because the game considers bad gas a good pill. I don't know why. Alright, I have my death card. Full up on health. I could charge my unicorn horn. Nah, I just end up taking a shit ton of damage trying to charge it. I'm just gonna go. No time like the present. Oh, I took out those eyeballs and I did a little chunk of damage, so I'd say the death card was effective. Wish I had more bombs. Bomb's heart is super easy if you have a lot of bombs. Alright, she's probably going to start spewing blood bombs any second now. Yep, there they are. All Alright, well, I think this devil door means I have the chance to go to Sheol. Noose is a good item. Glad I unlocked it. Why did my tears get so much faster all of a sudden? It's really weird. Oh well. I mean, I've come this far. Can't take the coward's way out now. Oh man, creepy music. I love it. Alright, I have zero bombs, which means fighting Satan might be a little bit of an ordeal. Normally I would just bomb this guy, but shit. Oh, dead end, eh? That's discouraging. Means it's not just gonna be a straight shot to the boss again. I already killed you, Monstro 2. Who the hell do you think you are? Who do you think you are, Monstro 1? I mean, come on. Damn it, stop spawning stuff. I'm trying to shoot you, not stuff. It'd be nice if you would cooperate. Oh yeah, that's true, Just Drop, I forgot about that. Just let my cube of me do the dirty work. Of course that takes a little while, but better than better than trying to do it myself. Aw, crap. Man, I wish I was actually fighting the Headless Horseman. Because I could get the pony. Be able to fly. Having the ability to fly is extremely good in this game. Jet. Oh, hey. Well, you're good for something, horse. I still have the Ankh too, don't forget. So if I do die, God forbid, then I'll have a second shot at life as the blue baby. Fuck! How was that close enough to hit me? Oh man, really? Shit. Do I actually want to fight this guy? Not really, but well, maybe I will stumble across something to spend money on. Probably not, though. This is going very poorly, very, very quickly. I should have said that stuff about having the Ankh, just in case I do die, because I put the idea of dying in the game's head. It's like, in case you die, you know, that's not a bad idea. Oh well, I'm here. Alright, I should probably save my unicorn horn and my magician card for after I die, because I'm probably going to die. And Satan with zero bombs or one bomb. I will try my best. And if I don't succeed, then hopefully the blue baby will succeed where I failed. Alright, let's kill this douche first. Alright, I have three hearts. So, things do not look good for Duke of the Bee. I'm gonna use my magician card, so the shots are a little heat-seeking. I'm gonna save my unicorn horn for... I'm gonna save it for the goat hoof part, because that's the hardest... That part's the hardest to hit him when you don't have bombs. So this guy is basically just like Krampus, except that he splits in two at some point. Which is very, very... unpleasant. Especially if you don't have a lot of orbitals. Because when they both start firing projectiles at you, then things get pretty hairy. Alright, Satan. I took out your minion. Best thing to do with Satan is to get him into this pattern and not stay in one place for too long. Because this is pretty easy to dodge, I say as I get hit. But that is a lot more difficult. Wait, does the go-hook part of him have a separate health bar? I thought it was the same health bar. Nope, I guess it is a separate one. No! I always misjudge when the unicorn horn runs out. Because you would think it would still be active like a second or two after the music stops. But actually, if the music stops, then it's already run out at that point. Well, it wouldn't be the Binding of Isaac without failure. Let's do one more run. And there's a specific run that I want to do before I end the stream. And that is the Doctor's Revenge. Which was, of course, by far the most fun challenge out of all of them. Because you start with this thing. Which I think is the best item in the game. There is the upgraded Dr. Fetus item, but there's the Super Fetus, which what that does is every time you fire a shot, it does one of these. The remote control bomb. Now I have the activated version of that item, but it doesn't happen every single time I shoot. And don't get me wrong, that's a lot of fun too, but it's also a hell of a lot easier to kill yourself with that one. I don't want to waste a hit to see what's in that room, so I'm just going to continue. Now if I can kill Satan with this, I can kill him with anything. Of course, actually, I don't think Satan, or I don't think Sheol spawns on any of the challenge runs. I think it's just Mom's Heart. Well, some of them are just Mom, but I think this one goes up to Mom's Heart, but no further. Oh yeah, that's right, there are no item rooms in this challenge, which, I mean, why would I need them? I have the Doctor's Revenge. What other items do I need? Well, maybe some hearts for after I hit myself like a moron. Man, I think that's the Book of Revelation. I would like to have that, but I doubt, stupid mouse cursor, I doubt I'm going to get 10 more coins. This guy might be kind of hard to hit with the bombs, actually. but it does stupid amounts of damage to him, so one more hit should take him out. Yep, there we go. Stem cells, nice. Okay. Cellar one complete. I wonder if you can get the no damage achievements during the challenge runs. I mean, it's probably not that much more likely that I would get them during this run, but having this item would probably give me the edge I need. I guess. Well, since there are no item rooms, there's really no point in exploring the whole level. I can kind of just get on with it. Hey, Monster One. Haven't seen you yet. Just your brother. Or your son. Or someone who is both your brother and your son. Hey, Monster Sooth. More HP? Alright, what you got for me, devil? I could get the shovel and make my way through the levels a lot more quickly, but I think I'm good. Curse of the Lost, that means, I think that just means it's a much larger level than normal. I forgot to check for secret passages on Basement 2. Bomb flies, eh? Well, let me tell you, I know a thing or two about bombs myself. Huh. I would get that if I had a way to get to it. Battery would be cool. It would make my doctor's remote charge faster, not that I'm really using it. I believe, among people who speedrun this game, the usual strategy is to just restart over and over again until you get a run where you get the Doctor's Revenge in level 1 of the basement. That's the that's a standard speedrun strategy. Which is kind of a bummer. That is not a very fun way to spend your time, because it is very, very unlikely that you'll get this item in 1-1. So that's a lot of restarting you'll have to do. So yeah, not the best game for speedruns. I think someone did a speedrun in this game at Awesome Games Done Quick once. But I didn't watch it. Maybe they just had, like, a run ready to go where he already had the Doctor's Revenge or something. But that wouldn't really qualify as a speedrun because, or a live speedrun, because he didn't start the game, you know, on camera. So, not sure how they handled it. Alright. Making some good time. Oh, I hate this guy. Try to use my my remote control rocket on him. It's hard to use because when you're paying attention to the cursor, it's hard to pay attention to everything else. I definitely got hit more than I should trying to hit him with that. Damn it, I wasn't expecting my bomb to get stopped by the blood pustule. So yeah, that's why I'm not really too big on the doctor's remote. Because, well, really, I should have used the mouse to control it instead of the arrows. Because it's a lot easier to keep track of, for some reason. Hey, corn poop. Haven't seen that yet. Oh, video games. Always making me say the dumbest sentences possible. Little buggers are surprisingly hard to hit with bombs. Oh, poop doesn't drop items when you blow it up? I didn't know that. I mean, not that you get anything good from poop. Usually, like, at best, like a nickel. Unless it's gold poop, of course. For only the finest connoisseur is a poop. Gold poop. Ask for it by name. Hey, the hoof. Not sure if it'll help me with bombs, but normally the hoof is very, very good. Gears up. What does the sun do? Oh, that's like, it reveals the world map and it does damage to everything on the screen, I think. That's a good one to hold on to. I'd rather have that than death. I wonder if Rebirth will have new challenges. Or if it'll have challenges at all. A lot of stuff is very up in the air still about that game. But I guess, just about 12 hours now, and we will answer that question, among others. I think the goat hoof might. I think it increases your shot speed normally. And since I'm using bombs, I think it makes them blow up faster. I'm not 100% sure though. Like it reduces the fuse time on it or something. Hard to tell. Doesn't seem that different. Oh, a ton more challenges? That's cool. Because a lot of people, they did their own challenges in this game to increase the replayability. Like, I heard people talking about, like, you know, really insane stuff, like, I mean, obviously, you couldn't do, like, a pacifist run, because there's really no way to proceed in the game without killing stuff. But, like, equally convoluted ideas. Like, I think people were using Cheat Engine or something to start with specific items. Like, they would do, like chocolate milk only runs or something like that. Chocolate milk is it's a power-up that lets you charge up your shots instead of just shooting individual shots. Which I don't like, because it makes it so you can't just hold down the button to shoot. You have to tap it. Like this. Tap, 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 tap. Which I thought was annoying. Aw, man, I hate this guy. Well, with bombs, it should be no problem. Wait. Did I hit it? It didn't look like it flashed. Weird. Main reason I hate this guy is because no health bar. You have no idea how much damage you've done to him and normally you can only hit him from the back, but since I have bombs, that's not really an issue. Still gonna be a little tricky to hit. I'm gonna have to plan my shots a little bit more methodically. Emperor, I think that just takes you to the boss room. You think it's something else? I'll hold on to the sun. It will be useful for fighting a boss eventually. Do I want to try to donate blood? Not really. I'll leave it there in case a bunch of hearts drop or something, but probably not going to mess around with it yet. Oh, hey. I've been forgetting to do that still. There are two secret rooms on every floor. I've been very, not diligent about checking for them. Of course, I'm so powerful that really not a big deal. Speed down, that sucks. Great. Yeah, hit yourself a bomb. Good idea. Good plan, Duke. Oh, I went the wrong way. If I want to get to the boss quickly. And you know, this is a speedrun, so I absolutely do. See, that's the thing, even if you get the Doctor's Revenge, a speedrun will still be, man, it must be so frustrating to try a speedrun this game because so much of it is just random chance. If you just happen to go the right way to get to the boss as quickly as possible. God, I can't even imagine. Of course, I can't imagine speedrunning most. Excuse me. I can't imagine speedrunning most games. Normally, do not have the patience for that. Blunky was a different matter. I didn't get the world record in Splunky or anything, but I still managed to beat it in under 6 minutes, which I thought was pretty good. Pretty proud of that. Probably the only game I'll ever speedrun, though. Just because I love it so much. I got all of the achievements in Shovel Knight except for the speedrun one. And I might go back and try to get it, I'm not sure. I love Shovel Knight a lot, but not as much as I love Splunky. Yet. I mean, I guess I can kind of understand, you know, people who just speedrun one game over and over again. You know, they just really, really, really love the game. You know? They feel about Mario 64 or Symphony of the Night or whatever, the same way I feel about Splunky, so I guess I can see where they're coming from. Okay, let's, shit. Blew that rock up the wrong way. Binding of Isaac, though, as much as I love this game, speedrun would just be a nightmare. Shit. I don't think I'm going to be able, well, fuck, I'll just lay a bomb down. Kind of forgot I had those. Alright, let's go back and put some coins in the slot machine since I have... Oh wait, that's the blood bank. That's the blood bank, never mind. I do not want to do that. Hey mom. Oh. Nope. That didn't work. Shit. Well, that did quite a bit of damage. Wow. Glad I held on to that. Pageant boy. Worst item in the game. Well, except for the poop. I don't know, the poop might give you more money over time than the pageant boy gives you. It's a tough call. But either one, I hate wasting an item slot on it. By item slot, I mean an item that the game gives you, because it doesn't actually like take up room or anything. But you know, that's an item that could have been something useful, and the game gave me something useless instead. I mean, even if I was playing just a normal run and there were item shops and everything, it only gives you like 6 coins or something. It's just not worth giving up an item. I'd rather have almost anything else. Except for, you know, the items I hate using, like chocolate milk. Bad trip. That's 2 bad pills I've gotten. Oh shit, I didn't kill everything on the screen before I left. So it all comes back. Oh, congrats, Pippa. That is good news. Unless you like desperately need to go to the dentist or something. In which case, my condolences. Ow, damn it. Bull honky. Death again? Really? Oh, that didn't do much damage to him. I love being able to kill those knights so easily. Shit. The knights are the one with the exposed brains. Oh man, horsey might be a bit of a challenge. Oh, there we go. Alright, didn't check for secret rooms or anything, but I think I'm okay. Flat penny. That has something to do with picking up coins. I think it gives you a key every time you pick up a coin or something along those lines. Eh, screw you. I'll just cheese my way through. Wonder if the trinkets are going to be the same in Rebirth. Oh hey, I'm pretty close to getting Kane. I only need a couple more coins. I didn't even realize I had this much money. If I don't get them before the boss room, probably, well, screw it. There's a heart right here. I will just pay a heart. Oh, well. Oh wait, I need one more. I thought I had 49. Oh, I guess Kane does not unlock during the challenges. Because I had 50 coins and didn't get them. Oh, wait. That's weird. Is it always 55? Huh. Very odd. I would have sworn it was 50. Maybe I started with 5 and just didn't notice it. So I had to collect 50 to unlock him. Not sure. Alright, here we go. Mom's heart with the fetus. Good to see that coming. Alright, like I said, Mom's Heart is super easy if you have a lot of bombs. You can just kind of sit here and spam bombs and kill the enemies as soon as they spawn. It's a good time for everyone. Well, mostly for me. Not so much a good time for the enemies. Mega fetus. Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot you have to do this challenge to unlock it. Wait, is it actually going to let me go to Shale during the challenge? Nice. All right, Satan. Time for round 2. Never got into it. Yeah, sorry, Bippo. I enjoy it quite a bit. Alright, now, I have to remember, just because I have Dr. Fetus does not mean I'm invincible. Still have to be careful. Especially around fast enemies like this, that are difficult to bomb. Shit. Oh, Dutch is hanging out, huh? He's hanging out in the room. That's good news. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, wow. I might not even make it Satan on this run. Won't that be embarrassing? I have infinite bombs and I can't make it to Satan. I didn't think I would be able to go to Sheol at all. Sheol. Oh, okay. My meat chunk got him. Good. Yeah, I know how you feel, Bippo. That's the reason I didn't like Mario 64. Because I didn't like the idea of having to go back to the same levels over and over again. And I can see how someone would feel the same way about The Binding of Isaac. But since it's a roguelike, that mitigates that intimidation for me. Because it's different every time, and, you know, it's entertaining. Unlike Mario 64. Nice. That's definitely helpful. Well, I'll be here a while. Give up. No, I don't want to. You know what would be cool? Like the Two of Hearts. I guess that would only give me 2 hearts. Chariot, that gives you 1 use of the unicorn item. That's cool. Pinky Eye, some of your shots are poisonous now. And I guess it carries over, oops, to the bombs. because, yeah. Looks like every third shot is poisonous. Well, maybe it's not that cut and dry. But yeah, Pinky Eye is, worth hanging on to, I think. And I will hold on to the chariot. What's this one? Oh, yeah, Hanged Man. Well, that sucks, Bippo. I think you should take him to People's Court. You have a lawsuit on your hands. Shit. Fucking horseless heads. Oh great, more. Exactly what I wanted. At least now I don't have the bomb maggots to worry about as well. Sucks to have wasted my chariot card already. Oh hey Oxbow, what's up? I thought the hoof was like increased fire rate. I might be getting that confused with cancer though, I'm not sure. I was never 100% clear on what all the trinkets do. And I have 40 bombs now, which, you know, I absolutely need. See if I can do this without getting hit. Yes, money. All right, well, I found a bunch of soul hearts. So, hopefully I am in a little bit better shape for this. Oops, that was my start menu. I hit the start button during the Binding of Isaac. Does not do anything. That bring up your start menu during the stream. Hopefully there's nothing humiliating in there. Alright, Satan. Round 2. Oh, I'll deal with your minion. Don't you worry your pretty little head. I guess that's a weird thing to say to the devil. But I stand by it. Ow. Get away. No. Stop it. Slow down. You piece of shit. You asshole. God. If I didn't get that speed down, I would be able to outrun these guys. Nope. Really? That's it? That's lame. 0.15? That doesn't sound like much. Wait, is that your speed or your shot speed? Not sure. Well, thank you, Oxbow. It's hard not to have a great run when you have Dr. Fetus, to be honest. Alright, well. Yeah, I think that'll about do it for the Binding of Isaac. I just wanted to have one more run with Dr. Fetus before I called it quits. And I didn't win, but that's very representative of a normal Binding of Isaac stream. You know, there were numerous streams where I just failed over and over again. Oh, it is shot speed. Okay. Well, that's a little bit better. Especially if it can exceed the normal bounds. That's pretty nice. If your shot speed's all the way up, you get the goat hoof. It can be faster than the maximum. All right, well, thanks everybody for coming out. Tune in about 11 and a half hours from now when The Binding of Isaac Rebirth will be unlocking on Steam, and I will stream it as soon as it's unlocked. And you can either tune in and watch, or you can play it yourself if you have pre-ordered it or you're planning on buying it. By the way, I think there's still time to pre-order, and if you own The Binding of Isaac on Steam, you get like a 33% discount or something, so like $10. I mean, it's not as cheap as the original Binding of Isaac was, but it's still a pretty good deal. So yeah, look forward to that. and hopefully Saints Row 4 later this week, or me and Moore's might just go on ahead and do a Rebirth co-op stream. We haven't really decided yet. All right, so until then, sleep well, everybody, and hopefully I will see you soon. Goodbye.